Détective Hercule Poirot? Ah, Chief Commissioner. On the contrary, it is a most convenient time. The safe passage of a painting? Tell me everything. If man was meant to travel the oceans in such conditions, he would surely have been given his own fins. A distraction is what one needs. Where is that blasted contact? How is one to prepare for an assignment if one does not have all of the required information? Very well. I shall wait no longer.
Beautiful, isn't she?
Pardon, monsieur?
The open water. There really is nothing quite like her.
When one suffers from the mal de mer, the beauty, as you say, is rather more a burden.
Forgive me, I just can't imagine being scared of the ocean in this day and age. The potential to see the world is open to even the ordinary man like us.
I can assure you, monsieur, it is not a matter of being scared. And as for ordinary...
I didn't mean to offend, mister.
I am...
Forgive me, madame.
No harm done. Accidents happen. My cigarette case, where is it?
I didn't see.
You thought I wouldn't notice? A young lady travelling alone, an easy target for you, I bet.
I'm sure the young lady would appreciate the help of two handsome strangers.
A young lady should not be left to gather her own things.
I didn't drop it on purpose.
Oh dear, what a mess.
A young lady should not be left to gather her own.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
A young lady should not be left to gather her own things.
You are returning home?
I am. But how did you know that?
Besides your educated accent, the crest that adorns your cigarette case, it is of British origin.
Very observant. It's the crest of my family, and the case belonged to my mother. I take it everywhere with me.
Miss Florence Farquhar, a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
The pleasure is ours.
That looks like everything, except for my powder case.
Is this what you're looking for?
It is! Thank you, Miss...
Miss Babanin. Anastasia Babanin.
Anastasia? What a beautiful name.
It was my grandmother's.
Well, that's everything now. I can't thank you all enough for your help.
I'd be happy to escort you. Here, I'll take your bag.
Oh, yes. Okay, thank you. Cabin 4. I'll be right behind you. Anastasia, perhaps I can offer you a token of my gratitude in the bar later?
That would be lovely.
And you, Mr...
Detective Hercule Poirot, at your service.
A detective? I was not expecting to meet such a distinguished gentleman on board.
I did not expect to meet someone of Russian descent on a ship between the great city of Antwerp and Dover.
I never mentioned where I was from either.
One did not have to. Anastasia, of Russian origin, meaning resurrection.
And here was me, thinking I was special.
Your knowledge of my heritage is most impressive.
And I'll take that as my cue to leave. Good evening.
It seems it's just us remaining.
I would very much like to hear stories from your homeland. Perhaps you would join me in the restaurant.
As charming as that would be, I'm feeling rather tired. It must be all the sea air.
Then I shall leave you to your slumber. Adieu.
As much as I enjoyed the delights of the restaurant, I still found my mind drifting back to Mademoiselle Babagna. She really was quite charming. I have spent the first part of this excursion neglecting my duties. It's time to retrieve my notebook from the safe and begin. The combination was not a difficult one to remember. 1815, the Battle of Waterloo.
Huh.
Et voilà. Time to... One cannot ignore such a blood-curdling scream.
My mother's cigarette case! It's gone! How could somebody do this?
Mademoiselle, I ask that you take a moment to calm.
You're a detective, of course. What luck!
As luck would have it, one of Belgium's finest. Now, I require as many details of the crime as you can offer.
I came to my cabin and began unpacking. I couldn't get the safe working, but the gentleman that helped me with my luggage showed me how it works. Afterwards, I went for a brief walk, and when I returned, the safe was open, and my cigarette case was gone.
We must consider the suspect list. Those who were aware of the cigarette case's existence.
That can only be those who were up on the deck when my luggage spilled. Miss Babagnin, the porter, yourself.
And your helpful stranger.
Yes, of course.
I ask that you gather them for me. And while you are absent, I shall begin my investigation in here, if Mademoiselle permits.
Whatever you need to do to find it.
Huh. Huh.
Mademoiselle, I thought you would be returning with a gentleman also.
The gentleman wanted to speak to the porter alone first.
I was unaware he is also a detective.
He's not a policeman. He works in insurance, I believe.
It appears I shall be spending my time chasing amateur detectives around the ship. Mademoiselle, I would like to start with who had access to the safe combination.
No one. It was in a sealed envelope that was waiting for me when I arrived. I memorized it and threw the paper overboard. 4, 3, 8, 5. It's really not that difficult to remember.
A similar envelope was waiting for me upon my arrival. The date of the Battle of Waterloo, as I recall. Every safe, although identical, must have a different combination.
After the gentleman helped me with the safe, he left.
If the mysterious gentleman is behind the theft, he went to great lengths to hide his fingerprints, but did little to hide his movements in Mademoiselle Farquhar's cabin. There are many questions that require answers, answers I believe he may hold. Magnifique.
Oh. Aha.
Mademoiselle Babanian, I'm sorry we must continue our conversation under these circumstances.
On the contrary, what fantastic luck that you are here. Now I get to see you at work. I'm afraid I've done very little, actually. After we parted ways, I went to my cabin. I had barely unpacked and I was fast asleep on the bed.
Alone?
That is a rather personal question, don't you think, Detective? I'm sorry, I'm a little nervous. A poor attempt at a joke. Yes, I was alone.
There is no need to be nervous. And then?
And then I was woken up by Florence's scream. I have never heard something so terrifying.
You have been most helpful, mademoiselle. I shall not take up any more of your time.
I'm sorry, but it's just not acceptable, Mark.
I've apologized to the lady.
And that makes everything all right?
It was an accident.
An accident that could have been avoided if you hadn't spent your morning drinking.
Gentlemen, you are behaving like two young boys in the schoolyard. It ends now. Is Mademoiselle Farquhar aware you are acting as her knight in shining armor?
I wouldn't go as far as that. I think perhaps we have got off on the wrong foot. I'm Arthur Hastings. Would...
She requested you to follow her to her cabin, no?
Oh, yes, she did, but I wanted to...
Speak with the porter privately? This was part of your investigation?
Well, I'm not a detective. I was just,
Then perhaps you will answer some questions that are vital to my investigation as a detective.
What can I do for you? It is. Is my employment relevant to Miss Farquhar's missing cigarette case?
I hope you will entertain me for a moment. What would you say the chances of proving a theft in a case such as this one are?
Well, a report from a detective like yourself will certainly help expedite her insurance claim.
As I thought.
It had perhaps not crossed her mind before. But being amongst an officer of the law and an insurance man, the idea of insurance fraud may have appeared appealing.
I'm what some would call a middleman. I oversee the handling of recently sold items and put the buyer in contact with an appropriate insurer.
The mention of insurance initially sparked my attention, but the more he talks of his work, I believe he may be my mysterious contact from Lloyd's of London.
It was your work that took you to Belgium?
I can't go into too many details, but I'm actually delivering a rather special piece of art to London. I'm meant to be meeting an official of some sorts that's supposed to be helping me, but no sign of them yet.
And it is confirmed. It concerns me that my supposed trusted colleague has found himself involved in the middle of my investigation. I will continue to withhold my true identity and see how Monsieur Hastings' involvement concludes.
When Florence, Miss Farquhar, told me that something had gone missing from her safe, I thought it must have been the porter.
How so?
I'd rather not say, with him standing just there.
It is not I that controls the volume of your voice.
You must have noticed the smell of beer on his breath. I wouldn't put it past a man that drinks on the job to steal.
That is quite the accusation. And if you were correct, you wish to settle the matter with him privately?
I wanted to give him what for, but I suppose I lost my nerve.
Merci, monsieur.
This really is an exciting case. Anything I can do to help Miss Farquhar, please don't hesitate to ask.
Your enthusiasm has been noted.